Welcome again to Planet to Soul Astrology. Hope you all are doing well. And today I'll continue with the series of nakshatras. In last time I told a brief explanation about nakshatra, and today we will start with first nakshatra out of 27, that is Ashwini nakshatra. What is Ashwini nakshatra? So everybody knows this is the first nakshatra. Previously from Kritika it was counted as in Ashtottari Mahadasha. There is no mention of Ketu Mahadasha in it. So only from Surya Mahadasha they were counting. But as per time goes, things also change as per the experiences, as per the literatures. So now we will talk about Ashwini nakshatra. You know, in India so many people have this name, Ashwini Kumar, Ashwin, Ashwini. So maybe in previous days also and now also many people keep their child's name as per the nakshatra. So whoever are having this nakshatra, most of the times their Atmakarak planet or their birth nakshatra are of this Ashwini. Likewise, Swati nakshatra people are having Swati name, Anuradha is having Anuradha name. So as Ashwini nakshatra is having Ashwini name. So many people keep this name. Going ahead, what is the meaning of Ashwini? See, in different literatures, in Puranas also, different meanings have been given about Ashwini nakshatra or about Ashwini. Ashwini, the very first two and half word of Ashwini, that is Ashwa. Ashwa means horse and Vini means horse power. Ashwini means person with horse power or person with speed of a horse, or you can say power package person. We can call it as a power nakshatra out of all 27 nakshatras because it runs like a horse, not only mentally but also physically. So coming to the mythological story, everybody knows that Ashwini Kumar is the deity of Ashwini Nakshatra, and it is connected with the medicine because Ashwini Kumar was doctor of all devatas. In olden terms it is called Ashwini Kumar was Vaidya of all devatas. It is said that Sanat Kumar were the son of Brahmaji, and Ashwini Kumars, I am telling Kumars because there were many Ashwini Kumars, because in ancient time in Devlokas these devatas used to have 50-60,000 sons, not like only one son or two son like that, how Kauravas, there 100 Kauravas were there. So same way Ashwini Kumars were there, whose father was Sanat Kumar, and Sanat Kumar's father was Brahmaji. So this Ashwini Kumars were having inbuilt property of natural healing in them. They were in bulk, but then later on they all were distributed among different areas, and they were the doctor of devatas. So each devata had their own doctor likewise. So Ashwini is a Ashwa. So I already said that it is a speedy nakshatra, and that time Ashwini Kumar was the person who used to do all the medical aid, all the medical treatment, all the surgical treatment to devatas, and he was having very honorary position amongst the devatas. And its position in the sky, or its position, the stars which it is made up of, having three stars and having the shape of face of a horse. So that is why this Aries sign was also given to Ashwini Nakshatra. This Ashwini Nakshatra is also having shape of English J. If you see properly the nakshatra shape, and each nakshatra have their color, and according to color their fruits are seen. So Ashwini Nakshatra is of J shape. You can say the socks, it has a socks shape, leg socks. So it's in from 0 degree to 13.20, that is 13 degree 20 kala, is holded by Ashwini Nakshatra in Aries zodiac sign. Very first sign in the zodiac sign out of 12, from 0 to 320, 322, 640, 640 to 10, and 10 to 13, 20 degrees are given to Ashwini Nakshatra. So people who are born in this four charan of Ashwini Nakshatra have mesh in their mesh rashi. If they are having this nakshatra, any planet in mesh rashi in Aries sign, then they are bound to get Ashwini Nakshatra in their chart. But their charan may be different as per the degrees. If one is born in 0 to 320 degree, then we can say that Ashwini Nakshatra first charan, then up to 640, then second charan, then up to 10 degrees third charan, and up to 13.20 degree then fourth charan is over, and then next nakshatra gets started. So this Ashwini Nakshatra is made up of three stars. It is having Tirthamukh. As in last episode I told that every nakshatra has their mukh, that face, that is Adhomukhi, Urdhvamukhi, Tirthamukhi. So it is with Tirthamukh because it is a detached quality in it, Tirthamukhi nakshatra, and it has three stars in it, and the nakshatra swami is Ketu. Ashwini Nakshatra belongs to Ketu. So this person have very much features of Ketu within them, very strong features of Mars, as this nakshatra is placed in Mars zodiac sign, that is Aries. So these people have Mars and Ketu features in them. That is why it is said that Kujavat Ketu. So Mars behaves like a Ketu, or Ketu behaves like a Mars. So both are comfortable with each other, with their energy, with their speed, with their detached quality, or you can say with their welfare quality, I would say. Means these people are very socially activated people. They like to do good for others. They are always involved in healing processes. No matter they are doctors, they can be very good healers, very good surgeons they can be. In any kind of medical profession they can be. If as per the planet's strength one goes in the medical profession, no matter as a nurse, as a pharmacist, as a class 4 worker in hospital, as a doctor, as a senior anesthetist, as a junior anesthetist, anything these people are bound to become. Apart from that, many other fields person can go in with Ashwini Nakshatra, that is technical field these people can go. But some or other way they do have healing properties, natural healing properties within them. Just they have to polish it, they have to recognize their inbuilt talent, their inbuilt quality they have to recognize. So in this nakshatra we can see the braveness of Mars. Okay, we see the lavishness, or we can say the perfection pattern because of Venus. then we can say it has the intelligence process of Mercury, and then we can say it has emotional quality, it has attachment quality of Chandra. Why I am taking all these four planets name? Because they are divided in four charan. So when you are getting first charan of Ashwini Nakshatra, so that will be of Mars. First charan will be of Mars, because in zodiac sign, first zodiac sign comes of Aries, that is Mars. So first charan Swami, first pad Swami, first pada Swami is Mars. If you are born in second charan, that is 320 to 640 degrees, then your charan Swami is Venus, Shukra, because second zodiac sign is Vrishabha, Taurus. If you are born in third charan, that is 640 to 10 degree, then you are born in Mithuna, I mean Budh charan. So that charan has all the properties of Mercury. So person will be grabbing, or person will be getting more properties of Mercury in his nature, in his behavior, in his studies, in his intelligence. So Mercury will be the working Swami, I would say. And if person is born in fourth charan of Ashwini Nakshatra, that is a moon sign, zodiac sign, that is Karkata. So person is having quality of moon, more quality of moon within them. Even though many people are born in Ashwini Nakshatra, but they are, you know, very light hearted, or you can say they are very soft spoken people. So maybe they are born in the fourth charan of Ashwini Nakshatra, because charan is ruled by moon. So each and every nakshatra, four charan whichever they are having all different charan swamis in them. So accordingly we have to do the prediction, and accordingly we have to see the main and exact nature and features and properties of the person. Now when this nakshatra is seen in the sky, so as per Hindu months, in Ashwini month, Ashwini is a month's name, how is the Kartik month, how is Margashirsh month. So Ashwini month, whenever comes, this nakshatra is seen in the sky. So this nakshatra is having very light color, and this nakshatra have feature like if we see this nakshatra, it is seen that some type of steam is coming out of, or some fume is coming out of this nakshatra, and it is very hazy nakshatra, because that is why we say Ketu is having haziness within them, or it's with fumes, you know. So the steam is coming out, how the water, after boiling the water, the steam comes, same way steam is coming out of this nakshatra. That is why the tattva of this nakshatra is Agni tattva. Out of Panch Mahabodh, every nakshatra having some particular tattva. So this nakshatra is having Agni tattva. That is why people born under this nakshatra are having this feature of hastiness, you can say speediness in their thoughts, in their deeds, in their daily routine work. They are very fast moving people, and they get detached also very fast. See, most of the doctors, after performing the treatment or after performing the surgical procedure, they are not connected with the people. People go away. People do remember them for years together, but doctor doesn't remember unless and until any relation or any friendship is there, because it is his work, his or her work as a doctor. So that is, this is the quality of Ketu. It doesn't get connected to the patients. Same way, whatever profession they are doing under Ashwini Nakshatra, they never get connected with the people. Even though they work in public sector, if Surya is good in the chart, still they meet so many people in their life. Daily they meet hundreds of people, but they are not attached to people unless and until they are born in fourth charan, that they might get some qualities of emotional attachment with their patients or with the clients or with the people they are living with. So this is the basic feature of this Ashwini Nakshatra people. These people are we can say very good looking, with very good built, we can say, and they are very strong. This nakshatra is more suitable for males than females. Females born under this nakshatra also have very masculine qualities within them. Even though with body or with structure they are very feminine, or with thoughts also, but they have some features of males within them, this because this is a Purush Nakshatra. So we can justify or we can differentiate between females and males born under this Nakshatra. So more of male qualities are seen in the females born in Ashwini Nakshatra. They are brave, they take speedy decisions, or they get, being a female also, they get immediate detached from the people, from the family, or from their children, or whatever. Means they don't take, they don't carry forward, or they don't carry these things on their head that I have to do this, I have to do this. They are free flowing people, you know. In short, we can say that these nakshatra people are very sharp decision maker. They are very sharp in their deeds also. They speak very sharply. Even their talking style, their walking style, everything is very impressive, you know. Everything is impressive for them. Even their sense of humor is very good. If third charan born person in Mercury charan, then they have got very good sense of humor, means giving answer on the spot. Even though any charan nakshatra, these people are so sharp to give the answer on the spot, or finding the solutions on the spot. Immediately they have the solution, or they have the thoughts in the mind, and they revert back to the person. As it is a Agni Tattva Nakshatra, these people are prone to get acidity, skin allergies, or you can say hot tempered, hot flushes many a times. Even though they know that I have to be attached to this person or attached to my family, still their nature doesn't allow them to keep attached with the family. So maybe they may have some family issues. They may lack in marital bliss unless and until moon is good in the chart or Jupiter is good in the chart. These people are prone to suffer a lot in emotional relations. So now I will come to the Mesh Rashi. So in Mesh Rashi, this nakshatra, all four charan as I said, so Surya or Sun is the planet of this nakshatra and of this Rashi. So Sun is exalted in this Rashi, but when the Sun is exalted, when the Sun is in third charan, that is of 10 degrees, that is in Budh Charan Swami, because Mercury and Sun both are again friends, both are comfortable. So whenever Surya is in Mesh Rashi, no doubt everything, it is an exalted sign, but particularly when it is Parmochya Ansh, when it is highest degree, 10 degree, it will fruit the best to the native, and such natives are 110% achieving name, fame in their life. Whoever is having this Parmochya degree Surya in their chart, some or other way they are very popular people, and they get very good respect, very good cooperation, very good coordination with their colleagues, with their staff, with their family, with their friends, and they hold a very good reputation in the society. Why Surya is Uchcha in Mesh Rashi, in Ashwini Nakshatra? All these three things we have to see. So first we will say it is in this Ashwini Nakshatra, Swami is Ketu. So it is in Mars sign. That is why Ashwini is fond of Mars. So their comfortness comes. Then comes the Surya. Surya is our soul. Surya is Atma. And Ketu is liberation. Ketu is moksha. So whenever Surya is in Paramoksha degree or whenever Surya is in Mesh Rashi, it is said that Surya comes here to do Swarth to Paramarth. Swarth means living in present life and achieving the goal of spirituality, achieving the goal of liberation, achieving the goal of doing social welfare. So Swarth se Paramarth, we can say. In short, I say Surya in Ashwini Nakshatra, this is a Swarth se Paramarth. One more definition I would like to give here about Ashwini Nakshatra. If we see Sarvatobhadra Chakra, whoever knows about Sarvatobhadra Chakra, I divide it in this way, all four charans of Ashwini Nakshatra. So 0 to 320 degrees, whoever, whatever planets are there in Mesh Rashi, so it will be Taskarancha. The person will be very sharp and smart. Person may speak lies, or person may cheat others, not necessarily offense or making any crime, but person is smart to make other person follow them. In today's life, we can say that they are so smart that they know how to make people understand them and how to carry out their work from other people. So first charan is of Taskarancha. Then second charan is of Venus, I said. So that is a Bhogyancha. Bhogyancha means enjoying the lavishness of this Charan Swami. Venus is for material life. Venus is for enjoying the life, enjoying the deeds also. So it is a Bhogyancha, whoever is born in 321 to 640 degree. Then whoever is born in third charan, that is a Mercury, so we can say it is a Panditancha. Such people study so much, even if they are doctor, they do PhD, they do masters, they go abroad, they do thesis, they do lecturing the people, they do honorary post. So this is Panditancha. And then we go to fourth charan, that is of Chandra. So what this Chandra indicates? That emotionally these people are more attached. So these people are born in this fourth charan are of Saumyancha. Saumya means like Chandra. Chandra is very Saumya, char. So these people are very sophisticated, very soft. So this is Saumyancha. So these four charan are divided, and even the while doing the prediction, this helps a lot of Sarvatobhadra Chakra method. So about Ashwini Nakshatra, I have spoken many things about the Ashwini Nakshatra. So in anybody's Kundali, if Ashwini Nakshatra or planets of Ashwini Nakshatra is Dushit or if Ashubh or you can say which is not in strength or not strongest planet, these people are prone to suffer more in their life, health wise, socially, they are not settled fast or they don't get the return or they are not recognized in the society, or they are prone to loss their reputation, ya manhani, we can say in Hindi, manhani bahut jyada possible ho jati hai in logo ke liye. One more thing I would like to tell here, that whoever is having Venus in Ashwini Nakshatra, they make lots of money. Or even if they don't make lots of money, they enjoy a lot with all material and lavish things in their life, no matter via their relatives or via their friends or via their office or whatever. They are very comfortable people. They get all comfort level in their life. So going ahead about Ashwini Nakshatra. So if Rahu or Ketu is in Ashwini Nakshatra, they are having very good willpower also and very good resistance power also they are having, and they are prone to enjoy all the things in life. They are getting all the material enjoyment in their life, and they are very brave people. Or even Saturn, if is there in Ashwini Nakshatra, if it is in initial degrees, this Saturn, if Nicha also in initial degrees, still it will give good fruits in Ashwini Nakshatra. But if in initial, if it is in later degrees, then person has to work hard and hard. Now going ahead, I will tell you few muhurtas which can be given in Ashwini Nakshatra. As it is the very first nakshatra of the nakshatra series, so for starting any good work or for starting any new venture, this nakshatra plays very important role, and this nakshatra can be given as a muhurta, as it is very auspicious nakshatra. Starting any studies or starting any new course, Ashwini Nakshatra can be taken. Then if you are planning to go for pilgrimage, or you are planning to go for some abroad travels also, this nakshatra is best to start with. If you have already some vehicle, or you want to buy any vehicle, and if you want to go for tours and travels business, and if at all you want to start with a new good day, then you can select the day of Ashwini Nakshatra for starting any vehicle related business, or just making a new start of your own vehicle also. For doing any type of operation, you can select the Ashwini Nakshatra. Then for Gruha Pravesha also, means entering ceremony or new home ceremony, you can select Ashwini Nakshatra. Then you know, this pharmaceutical companies, they make the serums, they make medicines, powders, liquid medicines, syrups, all that. So for starting any pharmaceutical company, or for starting making any new medicine, or in Hafkin Institute also many this immunization serums are made, vaccinations are made. So this can be, if anybody really want any muhurta for that, then Ashwini Nakshatra muhurta can be given to start this medicine making. So so many nakshatras are there, but Ashwini is the major and very fruitful nakshatra. Now which is the tree of see, every nakshatra has aradhya vriksh, aradhya tree, means their nakshatra tree, every nakshatra is having. So Kuchila is the aradhya tree of Ashwini Nakshatra, of Ashwini Kumar. So if you google it, you will get the meaning of Kuchila tree. If at all it is advisable that you should keep the branch, or you should have some bonsai also of Kuchila tree in your house, that is your nakshatra tree, it will always help you. Or you can just keep a branch or small piece of the branch with yourself, it will be very beneficiary for you. So if at all you don't have any of Kuchila tree, if you are not getting it, Adulsa is the alternative tree of Ashwini Nakshatra. Adulsa, you can google it. I googled it, but I don't remember the name. I just saw in the google, but I don't remember the name. So Adulsa, if you will type, you will get the meaning of that. It has specially for severe cough this Adulsa syrup. That is Ayurvedic syrup. It is used. So Adulsa leaves or Adulsa tree you can go with. In your, if you have garden, proper garden, you can just plant a Adulsa tree, Adulsa plant, and you can just keep the piece of branch of Adulsa tree. You can always go for that. So only one thing you have to keep in mind, that whoever is having this nakshatra, and if you want to make a Guru Pravesh, as I told you that this is the best muhurta for Guru Pravesh, but if at all Ashwini nakshatra is falling on Tuesday, if Ashwini nakshatra is falling on Tuesday, you should avoid making the Gruha Pravesh. Only these things you have to keep in mind. So about Kuchala or about Adulsa, already I told you, and I hope that maximum things I have clear. One more thing I will add here, that it is a Mandalochan nakshatra. Mandalochan nakshatra means the things which are stolen or things which are not found. So these things can be found within little of efforts to the native, as it is a Mandalochan nakshatra. The deity of this nakshatra is Ashwini Kumar. So one can go with the Bij mantra of Ashwini Kumar, that is Ashwini Kumarabhyo Namaha. Ashwini Kumarabhyo Namaha. This is the nakshatra mantra of Ashwini nakshatra. These people are having very good healing within them, so they should polish their healing quality, I will say that, and then they have to take care of that acidity, headache, short-temperedness, everything comes in this. So all Ashwini people, just take care of yourself and do good to the people, because you are the best doctors in the world, you are the best healers in the world, and I wish you all the best, that do more and more good to the people, and all will be blessed with your healing energy and your healing capability. So thank you so very much for hitting like button. Really I feel very supportive with that. Thank you all again for subscribing my channel. Whoever has not subscribed yet, please subscribe my channel. Do hit like buttons, do share the videos if you like it, so that more and more people will get benefit out of it. So next session I'll come with Bharani Nakshatra. So stay tuned with Planet to Soul Astrology. Dhanyawad, sabka mangal ho.